Good morning, everyone. Surprise! I wanted to do a quick video so that I can give you some information about the Beauty Boss workshops that are going in every area. I'm going to the one in Miami on Saturday. Hi, Lucy. I love Lucy. On Saturday, it's gonna be all in Spanish. This one is gonna be in Spanish from 9 in the morning until 1 p.m. And there are so many different workshops going around the entire country. So I encourage you to go on your avon.com and look and see what is the closest in your area. We have to drive more than 2 hours to get to ours. So if you have to do a little driving, just get some people together so that they can all pitch in. But don't miss this opportunity, because it's going to be an incredible learning opportunity for your business, for your leadership, also for you to personal develop yourself as a leader, as a person. For those of you who are not in leadership, you don't need to be in leadership. This meeting is free for everybody. And please spread the word out. Some of the events are already sold out. But you know what? You never know. If you can't register, just go, because sometimes people don't show up and you might have vacancy and you'll be able to get in. This is a training that costs thousands of dollars, and the company is giving it to you for free, absolutely free. Take advantage of it. And also, I wanted to give you another announcement. On March 29, the Miami Sales Center is having a huge open house from 11 to 5 p.m. So this is an incredible event that they do once a month, where they have a lot of deals, gift with purchase, and also you're able to take advantage of the products that are not going to be, they're going to be discontinued because new technology is coming out, and you'll be able to take advantage of, buying those products to make your baskets, to do raffles for your customers. Anything that you can do to increase your sales, just take advantage of it. This is an event that is also free at the Miami Sales Center from 11 to 5 p.m. March 29. There's only 2 sales center for representatives in the entire country, and the other one is in Los Angeles. So even if you have to drive a few hours, take advantage of going there to any of those 2, because it's a beautiful center. It belongs to Avon for the representatives. You get the same commissions as a representative, and you'll be able to try out all the products. It's like an open house whenever you want to go. So thank you, everyone, for being here. Let me see who's saying hello. Hi, Lucy and Trina. Hi, Trina and Michelle, Melissa. Thank you, Michelle. How are you? Good morning. And Angela. Angelique, how are you, my beautiful friend? Adrian, hi. And Mickey. Okay, thank you so much. Thank you so much for being here. Yeah, I'm excited. Today I'm doing some field time. As many of you know, we're doing a lot of tailgating promotion at the tailgating, you don't have to, you can set up, and it's a free event. So basically, you know, with this event, you're reaching out to the community. You're not selling products. You are just promoting the opportunity. I encourage all of you to take the time at least once a day to set up somewhere for at least 1 hour. For those of you who are out working, who are working or so, or have responsibilities with the family, taking them to a doctor or, you know, caring for an elderly, whatever it is, just 1 hour, but get out of the house, because when you are out of the house, new opportunities come. I always say that, and it always happens to me when I'm out and about. I meet new people that are looking for me, and I am a walking advertisement. So get out of the house and just do your events for at least 1 hour, and if you don't want to set up for whatever reason, just make 20 contacts a day, just saying hi, putting the opportunity in somebody's hand, and just go home. Let me tell you, sometimes, like when I go out and I do my prospecting, I connect with people, but then nothing happens, and then all of a sudden, you know, things start falling into place. So it will all work out. You just have to, you know, continue to do things, the right things, consistently, and don't look at the results. I always say that, because we tend to get discouraged when the results are not there. So that makes us not want to do things, because we're not getting compensated. This is our business. And I tell you, when I look around, when I go in an area, and then I see a business that closed down because they just went out of business, and I say to myself, wow, you know, I'm open for business after so many years, after so many economy hardships. We're still open for business, and it's all because our efforts every day has to do with the goals that we set for ourselves and our business. So one representative asked me, how do I stay always so happy? Happy. And I'm generally a very happy person. To a point that sometimes, even if things are not going the way that I want to, I am still smiling. And you know, when I'm thinking something negative that is not going my way, then I correct myself and I say, you know, that's not what it's all about. So I kind of revert my thoughts and start thinking of something positive. And for me, something positive is to be able to meet my goals, to be able to say, I'm going to retire wealthy. I'm going to, you know, meet this goal. I'm going to save this amount of money. I'm going to buy this real estate property. We're going to go to this vacation. Those are goals that I set for myself that makes me happy. And no matter what your circumstances are, no matter what things turn out to be during the day, you have to make yourself happy all the time and just keep going. Be consistent. When people see you sad, when people don't see you not smiling, they are not gonna get inspired by you. They are gonna walk away, you know, because they see enough sad people in their life that they don't want to see anymore. So please smile and portray an image of happiness just by saying hi. You know, today's a beautiful day. Just post a pretty picture of you. We are all beautiful, and in our own ways, we our attitudes makes us beautiful. Sometimes, you might see a person that is not as beautiful, but when that person speaks, when that person says hi, smiles, then all her beauty comes out. And that's what I always look for. I look for a smile. I look for people that are happy. I look for people that wear a lot of colors, a lot of glitter. And those are the ones that I'm going to approach. Those are the ones that I'm going to open. I'm going to give them the Avon opportunity. And when I talk about the Avon opportunity, it's not just becoming a representative. It's the opportunity to become my customer. So we're here to service customers. We're here to give people an opportunity, and also as helpers, be open about finding helpers, about finding new customers and new representatives, and that's what it's all about. So I hope this message helps you. Go to youravon.com under leadership, and then under leadership, go to leadership incentives, and then on leadership incentives, go to events and meetings and register there. I also want to let you know that you can go to any meeting in anywhere. Like, for example, if you're on vacation and you want to go to a meeting in your area, yes, on vacation. I work when I'm on vacation. and you want to go to a meeting in your area, and the reason why I'm telling you this, because I have, gone to other places, and even though I'm vacationing, I might be able to meet somebody, or maybe I did an event, and then I go, and then I see a meeting in the area, and I'm like, okay, listen, let's just partner, and then let's go to this meeting so you can see what Avon is all about. One of the things that I realized when I started going to the meetings is that this is a meeting that you don't have to do, okay? I paid for rooms at hotels that cost me over $100 when I was doing my meetings. Before I had my training room at home, I paid a lot of money for those meetings, for gifts, for the meeting room, for food, and carry all those products and set up so that I can have a meeting for my team. So imagine the company is giving you a meeting that you don't have to do. It's my son, Austin. Say hi. You want to say hi? I'm on a live video.
Oh, okay. Hi. I just got done.
We'll talk later.
Okay, yeah, I have to go to work.
Bye. Okay, I love you.
Love you too.
Okay, I didn't want him to say something that he wasn't supposed to say live. So that's what happens when you're live. So, yes, and so this is something that you don't have to do. Something that you don't have to do. So a meeting expense that you don't have to incur. So I encourage you to take your team and drive them to the meetings. I do that all the time. I go pick them up, or I meet them in an area where they can go with me, because it's worth it. I am going to be encouraging somebody to continue to be excited. So by me picking them up, it's way worth it than me having a meeting and spending hundreds of dollars so that I can train my team. So think about it that way, you guys. When you're thinking that you're not going to go to a meeting, imagine that's your meeting, and that you're spending hundreds of dollars so that you can train your team or train yourself. You always learn something new. Don't think that because you have been with the company for many years that you can learn, you know, from someone else, from an idea that sticks with you. So, you know, and work around your schedule. I had to take my son to work this morning early. So what I did was, you know, I'm out already. So I started my day and I'm going to go do some tailgating and then I go home. And then he comes home whenever he's off of work, he gets a ride and he's back. So work around your family, work around what you do. Be happy and you know, just work. I give you this message many times. A lot of people, when things are not going well, they let everything go. They're like, oh my god, things are just awful. And you know, no, that this when things are not going well, you just have to buckle up and say, I'm going to work harder. I'm going to do this differently. I'm going to put in more hours. And when I say about working harder, it's not sweating and, you know, and doing heavy stuff. It's just putting in more hours in your business. Maybe, you know, going to bed later and getting up earlier. Because I remember when I first got started that I put in so many hours. Sometimes my husband would tell me at what time. It was 1 o'clock in the morning and I was still sitting in the office, you know, working. And then I had to do it all over again in the morning, you know, get up early to do appointments and then go home and catch up with my emails, with my work. And I did that every day, Monday through Saturday, to a point that sometimes the family would tell me, don't you stop working? And I'm like, laugh. And, you know, at the beginning it was tough because, you know, they would see me on the phone when everybody else was having a good time. And I wasn't making the money back then. I was just working hard and making a little bit of money. So, you know, to be able to... you know, to be able to have the mental strength to be disciplined enough to say I'm working on my goals, and even though I am making $20 every 2 weeks, I'm going to stick with my plan because I am no different than the ones that are making $8,000. 10,000, 20,000 every 2 weeks or more. I am not different and you are not different. So please make sure that you take control of your business and that you don't pay attention to what other people say, because it can be discouraging when you're not making the money and everybody is making fun of you, saying that you're working hard, that you're working for a little bit of money that is not worth it. We all had to go through. But remember, at the end of the journey, you're gonna say, you're gonna laugh because I laugh. You're going to laugh at everybody who made you feel bad, okay? Because you are making big money, money that they will never imagine they will earn, because they're working for somebody else, because they are stuck in a 9-to-5 job, because they just, you know, can't make any more money. But you can with your Avon business. So believe me, trust me when I tell you this business pays, but you have to put in your time. Okay, and when you see things hard, you know, people not coming in regarding of how much you work, then you have to put in more time. You have to work harder and be more consistent and make sure that your goals are together with the amount of time that you put in your business. So let me see who's saying hello. Hey, hi, Tammy, Jennifer, Lottie, thank you, Chuck, Ruth, Tammy, Patricia, good morning, everybody. And Angela says, all your messages have helped me so much. Thank you for sharing. Judy, you're here. Annabelle, superstar. Thank you. Angela says, I'm trying to figure out where to have a fundraiser for someone that won't cost a lot. Can't have it where I live. Well, you know, if it's an events fundraiser, Angela, then set up in a place. It might also be at a friend's house. You know, look for friends who live in a community. A lot of the communities have their own room for social events that they can either rent or is given for free. And make sure you advertise that on your social media, that you get as many people as you can involved, so that when you are at that fundraising event, that you have the attendance, people that come to buy. So that's an events fundraiser. When you're doing a regular fundraiser, you don't have to rent a place. You just have to have your participants. And the average earnings with 20 participants, it's $2,000 for the organization. That's a $5,000 sale. So I'm not sure what kind of fundraiser you're doing, but I gave you two choices. Look at my fundraising videos on my channel, Avon Wings, and ask a lot of questions, because it can be confusing, especially when you're starting. Hi, Annabelle. My beautiful Annabelle. Hi, Yvonne. Can't wait to see everyone in Miami. Oh, so you're going to be in Miami. Yes, I will be there. So picture time. Hi, Susan. Analia. Hola. And Candy. Thank you, Candy. It's for an individual person. Yeah, so if it's for an individual person, then you would have to get the people that person knows involved, their friends, their family, everybody that person knows, so that they can be part of that fundraiser and determine if it's a participants fundraiser or an events fundraiser where you're going to have the products there so that people can come and buy, okay? So, and okay, yeah, I hope I answered your question. So, yes, just ask questions. When I'm live, ask questions, because that's why I come out live. I know that a lot of you communicate with me through Messenger and Facebook, but I want to be able to, you know, to help you so that you don't have to go through the struggles that I did. I struggled a lot. Good morning, Maria. How are you? Great. I know who you are. Okay. So, yes, you did. Thank you so much. Subscribe to my live videos. I try to just do one when I have time in between. I'm not set up to do videos on a specific time, because I run a crazy schedule, and I don't want to commit to something that I can't do. So for now, it's live whenever I'm live, and it's not because I can't set up that time. It's because for me, live videos are low priority. Where, you know, if I have an event, that's more priority to me. You know, when I have a meeting with my team, that's high priority. But that's why I can't schedule live videos, live trainings on a specific time or day, because it's not one of my big rocks. It's a little rock. So identify your big rocks and your little rocks. And sometimes you have to say no to some things, you know. Sometimes you want to be at every trip. Sometimes you want to be at every place. But your priorities have to do with whatever you think it's important. And you have to say no a lot of times, even when you want to say yes, even when you want to go, you have to be able to say, no, I can't go this time. And even though it's sad, you know, you just can't go. So, yes, Chuck, you can ask questions. As I get more experience, I'm going to pay it forward like you are. Oh, thank you, Angela. But you know what? You can start now, because what I have found is that with every live video, every question that I answer, whether it is on Facebook or Messenger or message, I generate another idea. So even though you might think, okay, you know, that person, and I know a lot of leaders think like that, that because that person is not on their team, that they're not going to help them. But in reality, we all learn from everybody. We are here for the same reason. So a leader, even if they're not, if she's not, she or he's not on your team, might give you an idea that you didn't generate by yourself. So learn from everybody. And if you are able to do an activity that's working, by all means, share it. You know, sometimes I share things that I know are gonna work because it have worked in the past, but it's just not working now. So I still share it, you know, and then I'm like, well, even if it's not working for me now, it might work for somebody else. So things like that, you get it, right? Okay, hi, Johanna. Yes. Okay, I got Johanna, thank you. Yes, thank you for being here. Chuck says, you are motivational genius. Well, you know, people ask me, why are you always laughing so much? And I'm like, because I really like what I do. I love what I do. You know, texting some of my leads, and I'm like, one of my leads tell me, and I laugh. I was like, wow. She said, I am working and you are disturbing me at work. So I don't want to be pressured into selling Avon. So lose my number. I was like, okay, thank you. Have a great day. And that was like funny. It was like, there's no need for all of that. You know, you have to just be polite. I'm working right now. I will get back with you. So do you think that you ever want to be associated with somebody like that? Somebody that is generally a sour person, a person that doesn't smile. She's not going to last in the business. So that's why I tell my representatives to always laugh, have fun. And I always ask them if I don't tell them this, ask them that I always tell them, I always ask them, hi, are you happy? And they tell me, oh, I'm so happy. I'm like, oh my God, that means she's going to be successful because she's happy. So thank you. I have a woman at church office to be very rude with me, set me back a day or two. Then I snap back and won't let that happen again. Well, you know how you can snap back? With kindness. Killing with kindness. So, and it happens to me so many times. Like when people try to be rude to me, I'm like, okay, thank you. And just book. But that generally doesn't happen. Most people are nice. Most people are good. And they want to be around other people. And you know, like sometimes I'm walking and I'm smiling, and then I get people saying, hi, how are you? And I'm like, okay, thank you, how are you? They don't even know me, but they just want to say hi to me because they can see how happy I always am. So be good to people, and just keep going, you guys. Even if it's not working, just, you have to stay focused. You have to consider that we all go through the same situations, that we are not unique. Everybody goes through the same thing. And believe me, the ones who are making a lot of money, they worked. They are working hard, because money doesn't come by staying home and not doing anything, okay? And I say it from my own experience. Things don't happen to me easily. I tell my husband that all the time. Maybe I need to remove that from my head. But, you know, things just don't happen to us easily. Opportunities don't come to us by just sitting down. And when the opportunity comes, we have to work at it really hard. So if you think that somebody's successful because they just sit at home and do nothing, you're totally wrong, okay? Yes, I had a woman at church. Okay. Yes, that Angela, you gotta keep going. It happened to me, but I won't. Don't give up. When you give up, that means you're quitting on yourself. I keep smiling, but was the first time my feelings were hurt. Then I realized she said something about how she used to sell and wouldn't let me talk to any, and wouldn't let me talk anymore. So I know I was her. Yeah, you know, it's people are for many reasons, the way they are. Just keep going and be happy. And don't worry about, you know, blocking people. Don't worry about that unless they're harassing you. But let them see how happy you are. Let them see that it doesn't matter if they like you or not. And most people, you know, even if they don't like you, they want to be around you. So it's funny, but yeah, that happens. They just don't like you as a person, but you are so positive and you're so good and you are who you are that they will continue to be around you. So thank you so much. Yes, Jean says, if you quit, I say you are dead in the water. Yes, that's like walking away. You know, it's, I always give that example, especially when I decide that I want to stop, that I don't have to go to a event that I already scheduled because I came up with something else. I always say, okay, if this was my job and I don't go to my job, what would happen? I get fired. So the same thing. When you decide that you're going to cancel your day, when you decide that you're going to cancel you, when you decide that you're going to quit, that means that you are quitting a job. And I want you to think of it as a job, because we don't generally get up and go from a job unless we have no other choice. But we can very easily walk away from our business because we don't have to be accountable to anyone but ourselves. So before you decide to quit, ask yourself, would I do this if I had a job? Would I just get up and quit? Okay? Because, you know, you can quit this business tomorrow and you can go get a job and continue to get jobs and continue to get jobs. And, you know, at the end, it's your success is what you have really put into it. And if you were strong enough to say, I will not quit, no matter how the situation is, no matter how bad I'm doing, I'm just gonna keep going. I'm just gonna keep working harder. So I hope this helps you, and please don't forget to go to youravon.com to register to the meetings. Even if your district meeting is not in your area, go look at other areas where maybe it's closer for you to go. If you're visiting family member and you have a meeting in your area, you can see them there. You can even schedule, like if you go to another area to do events and you have some time to go to this meeting, then you know, you can set some time aside and take your prospects to this meeting. You can go. Everybody is invited, okay? So thank you so much, and for being here and for asking questions. And I'll see you at the next meeting. Bye.